A very good day to all, and thank you for joining us at ITAP today. My father is an engineer, and as a young boy, I remember him explaining Moore's Law to me. For those of you who recall, Moore's Law comes from Gordon Moore, one of the founders of Intel. This law, which Moore observed, broadly states that the number of transistors on a microchip doubled each year. Over the years, many people have used Moore's Law to illustrate how the pace and change of technology have doubled every few years. Today, the pace and advancement of technology continues exponentially and in ever-shortened business cycles. Just look at the smartphones we carry today. Each year, multiple new models are pushed out, each more powerful than the previous. What does this mean for the industrial, in particular the manufacturing sector, which is so heavily dependent on technological advances to drive productivity, efficiency, and ultimately output? For one, it is inevitable that the pace of adaptation and change will increase. It also likely signals that those working in the sector must continually advance their skills and knowledge to keep pace with this change, and in fact, be the driver of this change. Early this year, Singapore announced its ambition to grow its manufacturing sector with a current value of $106 billion, equivalent to about US$79 billion by 50%. While this continues to maintain manufacturing at around 20% of Singapore's GDP, the manner in which we hope to undertake this growth is to be more focused through three nodes. The first, to continue investments in a manufacturing ecosystem. Second, to build further upon our existing research capabilities. And third, to promote Industrial 4.0 adoption more pervasively. What we want to achieve here, otherwise known as our Manufacturing 2030 vision, is to continue building Singapore's industrial sector as a global business, as well as an innovation and talent hub for advanced manufacturing. Our aspiration is for Singapore to be the center of advanced manufacturing, a hotbed where industrialists and innovation can come together. And to meet this target, collaborations not only between the private and the public sectors, but between the private sector itself, both in the vertical and horizontal spheres, will be critical. Today, the 600-hectare Jurong Innovation District, or JID for short, master-planned and developed by JTC, is home to a growing ecosystem of leading industrial players across the entire industrial value chain. JID is a long-term project for JTC, and for Singapore as well, and once mature, it will not only be home to various advanced manufacturers, but also research institutes and capability developers. We have just completed a new phase of our Cleantech 2 development, and with the completion of Cleantech 3 next year, almost 60,000 square meters of R&D and collaboration space will be added to JID. Today, we already have many committed companies who are planting their flags at JID as well. They include Shimano's Factory of the Future, as well as Hyundai Motor Group's Innovation Center. Both are coming on nicely. I was just speaking with Hyundai's Singapore representative recently, and they are pushing aggressively towards completing their buildings in the coming years, so as to be a first mover in JID and to take advantage of what JID has to offer in the long term. And for our research institutes and capability developers, JID today already houses McKinsey's Digital Capability Center, as well as the Advanced Remanufacturing and Technology Center and the Singapore Institute of Manufacturing, both affiliated to Singapore's Agency for Science, Technology and Research. In addition, within the confines of JID, there will also be Industry 4.0 solution providers, such as Siemens, Makino, Sodic and Konica Minolta, as well as training providers and institutes of higher learning, such as Bosch Rexroth Regional Training Center, Advanced Manufacturing Training Academy, and NTU. We believe that with the necessary stakeholders and players all within one locality, this will be the first step towards building a unique and whole ecosystem where businesses can innovate and grow and at a much faster pace. JTC's traditional role has always been in the real estate sector, but with JID, we believe in going beyond just brick and mortar and fostering a vibrant community where JID can be a beacon for I 4.0 and where like-minded partners come together with us to fulfill Singapore's M2030 vision. Here, I thought it useful to share some examples of how some collaborations in JID between various parties have already taken place. Many of these businesses see the value of partnering global I 4.0 solution leaders to grow capabilities and have done so. The first example is FlexMac Engineering, a local homegrown 37-year-old business supplying precision equipment and services to clients across different sectors around the world. They tied up with Bosch Rexroth to create an Industry 4.0 light solution that businesses can adopt with FlexMac machine. Through this, the result was extending machine longevity and achieving savings of up to $250,000 annually. The next example is a tie-up, or try-up, because it involved three parties between ARTC, JM Vistec, and Procter & Gamble. This tripartite collaboration between a local SME, researchers, and a multinational corporation was aimed at developing an I 4.0 solution for SK2, one of the many well-known brands under P&G. Through this collaboration, an automated inspection system powered by AI for glass bottles used for SK2's products was developed. The outcome? Tripling the speed of inspections for the packing line for P&G. And finally, a third example, one between Siemens, A-Star, and the National Additive Manufacturing Innovation Cluster, or known as NAMIC. Here, partners collaborated with local researchers for a 3D-printed face shield during the COVID shortage in the past year. Subsequently, Siemens increased its production from 200 to 3,000 pieces each month, with consequential improvements to the design and manufacturing of such face shields. I should not forget to mention that A-Star helped to develop the final product with the right medical coating. While through NAMIC, Siemens connected with partners such as HP and Jabil, who provided necessary machines and technical expertise to scale 3D printing. What I've just shared shows how important it is to develop a framework for connection within the JID ecosystem and a mindset of collaboration for common objectives and outcomes. Through our Industry Connect schemes, more than 1,000 businesses in our estates have participated in various Industry 4.0 outreach. Significantly, an estimated 250 SMEs are currently undergoing various phases of digitalization, transforming their businesses and turning the current ongoing COVID challenges into opportunities. Now, I will also be the first to admit that when we first embarked on this I 4.0 journey, it was not easy. Try telling any SME in the past about digitalization, and the first reaction we get is that it is expensive and not applicable to small companies. But through engagements and subsequently seeing the various programs offered, their perception slowly changed. Today, many SMEs understand the longer-term benefit of digitalization and working with different partners to enhance and improve production and productivity. What we need to do now is to walk the journey with them, and through various support schemes and grants provided by the government and industry partners, provide them with that edge to keep them competitive. The result, not only in reduced operating costs, but also redesigned workflow and processes, and increase in machine utilization rate. Productivity is immediately uplifted, leading to higher sales and higher margins. Interestingly, we have also observed that there is a discernible change once companies transform. Not only are laborious, repetitive, and mundane tasks eliminated and replaced by machines and technology, but knowledge is increased through taking on higher value-added tasks, such as data analytics and operating high-end machines. Net-net, this becomes a win for all, with companies and employees benefiting all at once. And in addition to what I have just mentioned, we have also pushed ahead with our industry days for students, such as our Biopharma Industry Day, Electronics Day, Aerospace Day, and so on. Our intent, not only to connect businesses, but also to build the future pipeline of manpower and resource, and ensuring that there will always be a good pipeline of talent into Singapore's industrial space. What next for i4.0? Our efforts have only just begun. Going forward, we will be accelerating our i4.0 efforts and within a more systematic framework. The intention is to help us scale i4.0 beyond what we are currently doing. We have just set up a new Industry Connect office, and we are partnering with EMTA to provide consultancy and advisory services on i4.0 skills and training to all. Companies and businesses keen to transform or to improve will be matched with partners where problem statements can be identified, solutions discussed, and relevant upskilling programs matched. But that is not all. We also have more than 10 community of practice partners, such as Siemens and Bosch Rexroth, under the Singapore Business Federation's i4.0 Human Capital Initiative Enabler Program, come together to help interested companies with their next phase of deployment and scaling of i4.0 solutions. This forms part of the continual support structure put in place to uplift businesses from front to back and to reach the intended eventual outcomes. In the meantime, we are also creating platforms and formalizing partnerships to advance sustainable manufacturing in Singapore and Asia. It is an exciting journey which we at JTC have embarked upon, and one which we are committed to continue. At JID, we are putting the foundations and building blocks for the next phase of manufacturing and welcome all of you to join us on this path. I hope to see all of you at JID soon. Have a great day, and thank you very much.